It's now time to further develop the design by adding openings to the building. Let's first add an external door to the project. ArchiCAD's door, window, and skylight objects are intelligent parametric library parts with a tremendous range of configuration and setting options due to their parametric behavior. This accelerates your work, makes the management of the project easier, and allows you to design instead of draft. In practice, this means, for example, that you don't need to delete and look for another window object if you want to change its size, sill height, adjust its frame, sash, oversize, board, or casing properties. You can even specify shutter options using various shutters and glazing types and choose from a variety of handles. All these are available and valid for the very same window object. You may continue working on the current project, or open the ACTS03 Chapter 2 PLN ArchiCAD Solo project file to complete this chapter of the training series. In the 3D view, navigate to see the entrance area of the building. Activate the door tool in the toolbox. Open its settings dialog by double-clicking on its icon on the toolbox or on the info box. Doors are GDL objects and have parameters to control their appearance and behavior in the project. Type asymmetric into the search field at the top left of the dialog to find all available asymmetric doors. Select the double door asymmetric door object in the result list. Set parameters as follows: width 1.50, height 2.40, anchor. Select Relink Anchor Story from the roll-down list, and select 0 Ground Floor. Sill to Story 0 to 0.00. Reveal to Wall Core, minus 0.10. This is the thickness of the insulation. Anchor. Anchor point middle. On the hinged door settings, general settings page, uncheck casing out and casing in, and choose normal threshold. Set a value of 1.00 on the shape page of the hinged door settings panel. On the door leaf type and handle page, select a leaf style 20. Select No Mullions on the side panel page. Tags and categories. Non-load-bearing element. Exterior. Door. Click OK. With special snap points, half option turned on, move the cursor over the wall segment. Click the appearing snap point at the bottom to place the door. The outline of the door appears in the wall. Now, move the cursor to pick the external side and the right side, indicated with a dashed line. Here's the final door in the wall in 3D. You can also check the result on the floor plan. We need some additional doors facing the veranda. Switch to the zero ground floor. Open the door settings and type sliding in the search field to find the sliding doors in the library. Select the sliding door and set its settings. Size 3.0 and 2.40. Sill to Story 0, 0.00. Reveal to wall core, -0.10. Anchor, slide 2. No casing in the sliding door settings. Place doors on the left and right vertical walls, starting in the left corner, and one in the horizontal wall. First, define a horizontal guideline by clicking on the orange dot on the internal surface of the wall, and not the core of the wall. Now, place the sliding door into the vertical wall by clicking on the intersection point of the guideline and the external surface of the wall. This defines the external side. Now, click on the upper left side of the door to define the opening direction. Before placing the door into the horizontal wall, change the anchor to side 1. Create a vertical guideline along the internal surface of the vertical wall on the left. Click the intersection of the vertical guideline and the external surface of the horizontal wall to place the door. Move the cursor towards the lower right side of the new door to define its opening direction. Let's place another sliding door into the vertical wall on the right side. First, we'll add a horizontal guideline along the internal surface of the horizontal wall. Click the intersection point of the guideline and the external surface of the vertical wall to place the door. Move the cursor toward the upper right side of the door to define its opening direction. Select the sliding door in the horizontal wall segment. Click on its upper right corner to bring up the PET palette. Click the multiply icon to bring up the dialog. Set 2 as number of copies, and distribute as method. Click OK. Click the same corner point of the door. Then click the inner side of the right wall corner to distribute the sliding doors evenly. Hit Escape to remove selection. Please note, you can change the 3D opening angle independently in the 2D representation. This way, you can use the same element for visualization purposes. Select a sliding door. Open its settings and go to the Parameters tab. Click on the opening item and change opening width and 3D value to 0.90. Check that there are no changes on the floor plan. Open the 3D window to see the door with the new opening angle.